Hi again, Henrik from the loadUI team here. In this video, I'll be showing you how to get started with assertions. Let's get started.
So, let's start by creating a simple web load test containing of a fixed rate generator and a web page runner. There we go. We connect the two. Set the request rate to 1 per second and enter a URL to server. It's just a static web page basically. We start the test and go to the statistic workbench to see what's happening. Here the orange line is time taken, which in this case means response time basically. We can see that it fluctuates a little bit, but mostly stays below 100 milliseconds. So now, going to assertions. Let's say that we want to assert that the response time never exceeds 100 milliseconds. We can do this by going back to the main window. Wow, that was a spike. Anyway, back to the main window, open the assertion panel, and since we want to assert a value in the web page runner, we drag the web page runner to the empty assertion list. Choose time taken, and I'm going to choose our real time value, no aggregates, and the max will be 100. Then I need a name. Let's call it max 100 ms. There we have our assertion. It's already produced two failures. 3, 4, as you can see. Let's go back to the statistic workbench. Well, it seemed to be correct, right? 5 failures? Well, maybe. Sometimes the orange line seemed to be above 100, but it's hard to see where the failures are actually occurring. For that, we can add the assertion to a chart. You can see it says max 100 milliseconds there. So let's drag it to the chart. And there you see all the failures, 14 failures marked as green vertical lines. 14 failures may be a lot for you. So let's say that you want the test to end if you reach, let's say, 30 failures, because that's a lot to you. So then it's no reason continuing testing. We go back to the main window, click the limit button here, and set the failure limit to 30. What happened now is that a green bar appeared. You can see it increasing. When that green bar fills the entire length, then we have reached 30 failures and the test will stop. So let's wait for it. 28, 29, still running, 30, there we stopped. That's it. Thank you for listening.